Well, soccer is pretty cruel. You know, I give up a goal that, you know, we shouldn't have given up, and that's uncharacteristic to this group. And we come out, we continue to be relentless, and we got better throughout the game. You know, like we give up the goal, we found another gear, and the ball didn't go in the net. You know, I hate to come and say and talk about how, you know, we one more inch or take another half chance, you know, but that's the reality of the game. We didn't score, and we created enough to do so. We got the ball wide, we got the ball in the box, top of the box, dominate possession, press them high. Didn't get the win.
It was another really scrappy game. At this point, would that almost think be the downfall of the team today?
No, we're proud of our identity. You know, we're going to be a team that's difficult to play against, and something our opponents really had to come prepared and step up, and I felt like it was actually an advantage for us in the game.
What was the message to these guys at the half?
Look, we're playing really well. We got to continue to step up and press. Our advantages were in wide positions, and we needed to get it there and then find a way closer into the middle of the goal. You know, it's very tactical, it's confident. Typically, it's led by our leadership, you know, Garrett and Eve and Nolan. You know, these guys, they see what's on the field. We had a few 2 cents, but, you know, these guys, they knew they had control of the game. We knew they were doing what we were supposed to do. Didn't fall away.
You say an inch here, an inch there, but like Alex's shot from distance a couple times, natural couple, like they were really like an inch or two away from you guys from tying it. Does that make it harder to swallow at this point?
Yeah, it always does. You know, like I think the hard part is like we played really well. We played really well. Played really well against UNH, and you know, I felt like we deserved more in the match. So, you know, you want Nagy to take more shots. You know, you want Nacho. Nacho had some really close ones too. Credit to the keeper. They made some good saves, or the back line blocked some good shots. You know, they ended up being committed there and defended all 11 players, and they got the result, you know. So I think, like, we talked to the team after the game. It's like, and Nacho said it best, we're not going to have Nacho next year. And, you know, he said, like, next time you get in this position, make sure that we win this game. And it's going to be a burning feeling all throughout offseason. But this was our game. It was our game to win.
You mentioned what Nacho said. What do you say to the team after you just said, you know, you played a great game, just didn't win? What do you say in a time like that?
Yeah. I particularly address Nacho for what he's, you know, this guy came into our program for 3 months and, you know, instantly inserted experience and leadership, and to honor what he has accomplished with this team. You know, when we're in the locker room, he's the guy that people look to for courage and strength in big games. And he showed it tonight. The guy played off the charts. And so really proud of what he did, mostly.
Did you get any explanation on the potential PK? I think Nacho got taken out from behind. You know what I'm talking about?
Yeah. There is no explanation.